Here we go, the money ball. If I make it, I send this guy home crying. If I miss, I send him home crying. You see, we're playing for 100, and I've only got 20 on me. Either way, it's better for him if I make it. Dealing with my game is one thing. Dealing with me is a whole other story. Better for him I make it. Besides, this guy's been sharking me the whole time. Making little noises on my takeaway. Let's see. It's a tough shot. Long, about a 19 degree angle. No chance of scratching. I know where to hit it. Just gotta put a smooth stroke on it. Man, these pockets are tight. But I know what I'm doing.
Eddie, let's do this later. Charlie, glad you could stop by. Terry, we need to talk. Well, nothing's ever stopped you from talking, Charlie. Terry, the grapevine says you picked up a subpoena. That's right. Terry, the boys know you too well to mark you down as a cheese eater. And they're getting interested in your future. Johnny and the boys think that you've been left out of things. Maybe, Terry, it's time you had a few things going for yourself down in the docks. A steady job. A few bucks in my pocket. That's all I ever wanted. You know, that's fine, Terry, when you're a kid. But you're pushing 50, slugger. It's time you got a little ambition. I always thought I'd live a little bit longer without that. Terry, there's a slot for a boss letter opening up on our new pier. 10 cents for every 100 that moves in and out. You don't lift a finger. That's 300-400 just for openers. And for all that dough, I don't do nothing. Absolutely nothing. You do nothing, you say nothing. You understand, don't you, kid? Yeah, I guess I do. But there's a whole lot more to this than I thought, Charlie. A lot more. You don't mean you're thinking about testifying against me and Johnny. I don't know. I ain't made up my mind yet. That's what I want to talk to you about. Look, Terry. These piers we run through the local unions. Do you know what they're worth?
Yeah, I know.
Well, then you know that Johnny ain't gonna jeopardize a setup like that for some rubber-legged has-been.
Don't say that. I tell you, Charlie, I could have been a lot better. A lot better.
Ah, what the hell? The point is, kid, there isn't much time.
I tell you, I ain't made up my mind yet.
Well, I'm telling you, kid, you make up your mind before 11:30 tonight. I'm begging you.
11:30 tonight? What's gonna happen at 11:30 tonight, Charlie? What's gonna happen?
Take the boss loading job, kid. For God's sakes, I don't wanna hurt you.
Mm-hmm.
Charlie. Oh, wow. Wow. I wish I didn't have to do this, kid. How much you weigh, kid? When you weighed 165, you were beautiful. You could have been another Billy Conn. Hadn't been for that skunk manager I hired. He brought you along too fast. It wasn't him, Charlie. It was you. You and Johnny. Remember that night in the garden? You came down to my dressing room and you said, "Kid, this ain't your night. We're going for the price on Wilson." Do you remember that? Not my night. I could have taken Wilson apart that night. So what happens? He gets a title shot outdoors in a ballpark, and what do I get? A couple of bucks and a one-way ticket to Palookaville. You was my brother, Charlie. You should have looked out for me just a little bit. You should have taken care of me just a little bit so I wouldn't have to take them dyes for the short-end money. I put some bets down for you. You made some money. You don't understand. I could have had class. I could have been a contender. I could have been somebody. Instead of a bum. Which is what I am. Let's face it. It was you, Charlie. Take this, kid. You're going to need it. Okay, Eddie. Let's do it. 200 a game. Rack 'em.
It was you, Charlie. It was you. What a baby you are.
Charlie, you know it.
Cry baby.
Oh, yeah. Oh.